haven't been the same since you came into my life. You found a way to touch my soul, and I'm never, ever, ever gonna let it go. Happiness lies in your own hand. It took me much too long to understand how it could be until you share your secret with me. Baby.
Shit on me.
Why don't you just deal with it?
'Cause I'm not sorry.
Forbidden love, if I only had one dream, this would be my Oh. till about the night is over. This masquerade is getting older. Lights are low, the curtains down. There's no one here. Say your lines, but do you feel them? Do you mean what you say when there's no one around? Watching you, watching me.
All right, so we made it through the wilderness. No, We made it through the live stream of Bedtime Stories original album versions of songs with my videos to commemorate the 30th anniversary of the release of that album by Madonna in 1994. Okay? And I really hope that YouTube does the right thing and leaves my stream and my channel alone, because I haven't done anything wrong. Okay? Yeah, they gave me a warning, third song from the end there, that they detected audio that belongs to someone else. No shit, Sherlock. Yeah, it does belong to somebody else. It belongs to Madonna. I'm aware of that. Everyone is aware of that. Okay? But just because it belongs to somebody else doesn't mean that I'm not allowed to use it. Because most of those songs, like, I didn't have to make new videos. Those are videos that I've already made a long time ago and are already on my channel. So just about all of that content that we just saw there is already on my channel. Okay? So if it's already on my channel, it means that, yeah, it does belong to somebody else, but it's already on my channel because the copyright holder has agreed to allow it to be used on YouTube. So that's what it says when I upload those videos, and that's why they are on my channel. So there's no reason, just because now it's in a live stream, there's no reason for YouTube to get their knickers in a twist and block it, or they could do worse. They could, like, I could fucking lose my whole channel. And you know what? If you fucking mess with me, YouTube, I will fight back. On this one, I will fight back because I know I've done nothing wrong. And I would welcome the media attention. I will get a lawyer. I will fight it. Okay? So I'm tired of being pushed around by bullies, and YouTube is a fucking bully. So, but not just YouTube. I'm tired of all bullies. So I'm going to be fighting back. Oh, yes. To anyone who tries to pull shit with me. Now, what else? Like, because what you'd be doing is you're silencing someone who should not be silenced. Okay? I'm already silenced to a large degree, but even more, that would be terrible. Okay, my hair looks kind of good, and it's just totally whacked. Like, I just came out of bed like that. I should say a few words about Bedtime Stories. Okay? So Bedtime Stories was released in 1994. And it was released following Erotica, which was her previous album before Bedtime Stories was Erotica. And then around the same time that she released Erotica, she also released her sex book. So prior to Bedtime Stories, Madonna was at her peak sexual. She was at her sexual peak. Well, what age do they say that women hit their sexual peak? Isn't it 35? Well, if she was born in 58, same age as my mom, she would have been 35 in 1993. Yeah, just right around before Bedtime Stories was released. And that does coincide with when her career had peak sexual content in it. She started to face a backlash against that. And so in the interest of survival for her career, she toned it down quite a bit for this album. Now, it's looking at this album by itself, you would think, really? Like, because there's a lot of sexual content in it still. I mean, it's called Bedtime Stories. These are not children's bedtime stories. But in comparison to Erotica and the sex book, this is toned down. And, okay, and then the next thing that she did after that was Evita, okay, the movie Evita, which was one of her biggest accomplishments of her career, and then she had her baby and released Ray of Light. So the next full studio-length album after Bedtime Stories is Ray of Light, and so you can think of Bedtime Stories as the transition album, the bridge between Sex Kitten Madonna and Mother Madonna, who's had a spiritual enlightenment by the time she puts out Ray of Light. So this is like the bridge between those two Madonnas. And you can see themes of both at play in this album. Okay, it's also the beginning of more of an electronica sound coming from her with the song Bedtime Story. Okay, so the album is called Bedtime Stories, but there's a song on the album called Bedtime Story, just singular. And that was written by Bjork, who I always think of as the mother of electronica music. I mean, I act like she invented it. I mean, I know she didn't, but in my mind, that's what I think of her as, because in the 90s, like, she was the first one to put out electronica music into pop music. Bjork did. And she also did that through Madonna, through the writing of the Bedtime Story song, which has an electronica vibe to it, that a vibe that Madonna pursued even further with her subsequent Ray of Light album. Okay. I think that's basically all I would want to say about that album. It's an excellent album. It really is. And I can't believe it's been 30 years. Like, we're all getting so old. Okay, so hopefully YouTube does the right thing and leaves me alone. Okay, just leave me alone. Don't cause trouble for me. I've got enough fucking trouble as it is. Okay, that's all. Peace out.